between the crosses rather than one above. That mark our place and in the sky. The larks stood bravely, sing and flock. Scarcely heard amid the guns below. We are the dead, short days ago. We lived, felt the world, saw the sunset glow. Loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw. The torch is yours to hold it high. If you break faith, with us will die. We shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Each year at the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, we observe a 2 minute silence. The Remembrance Day silence originated in Cape Town, South Africa, in 1918 by the Cape Town mayor after receiving the news of the death of his son by gassing in April of that year. Back then, it was a signal by the firing of the noon gun that is now initiated by a bugler playing the last post. The first minute is one of thanksgiving for those who have returned alive, whilst the second minute was to remember those who sacrificed their lives in battle. Today, we remember them all.
I will remember Lance Corporal Gary Dingley of the Parachute Regiment, who was killed during the Battle of Goose Green. The 28th of May 1982, the regiment were engaged in fierce fighting to take the well-entrenched enemy position in the area of Goose Green. Settlement on the island of East Falkland, Lance Corporal Bingley was a section commander. During the battle, his section came under fire at close quarters from two enemy machine gun posts. To destroy enemy positions, he led his section in the assault. Whilst leading, was fatally wounded. His heroic action enabled his company to continue their advance and was significantly instrumental in defeating the enemy.
This is a photograph of my great uncle Isaac Whitehouse and his wife Annie. Isaac was born in Coesley near Dudley in 1892. When he was 8 years of age, he moved to the north-east of England with his family. Isaac, a labourer in the Teesside ironworks industry, joined the Royal Naval Volunteer Reserve. He undertook training in his spare time at Tyne ashore. Isaac and Annie married in 1914, shortly before the declaration of war on the 4th of August. He was called up and served as a stoker on board HMS Defence. He died aged 23 on the 31st of May 1916, the Battle of Jutland. All 903 souls on board HMS Defence perished. We continue to honour his memory and many others like him that have given or dedicated their lives in service.
I will remember Corporal Simon Miller of the Royal Military Police. On the 24th of June 2003, following growing distrust between the British military and local people of the eastern region of Iraq, Corporal Miller, aged 21, with five other Royal Military Police soldiers, had visited the local police station to investigate an incident which took place 2 days before. As a result of the disturbance between the British forces and villages elsewhere in the town, an angered crowd of 600 started surrounding the police station. Soon the situation escalated and Corporal Miller received a gunshot wound to his upper body. Despite his injury, he continued to defend his position with the others in his unit. Unfortunately, the size of the crowd was too large to force back, and Corporal Miller, along with the other five RMP Their bodies were recovered at 13:40 p.m.
I will remember Private George Henderson of the 5th Royal Irish Lancers. Private Ellison left the British Army in 1912, but was recalled to the Army at the outbreak of the war in 1914. Ellison, aged 40, was the last British soldier to be killed in action during the First World War. He died at 9:30 a.m. on the 11th of November 1918. While on patrol on the outskirts of Mons, Belgium, 90 minutes before the armistice came into effect. He was survived by wife Hannah and son James, who only learned of his death just before Christmas, more than a month after the war had ended. Private Ellison's grave faces that of John's grave,
I will remember Captain John Wolford from Birmingham. Captain Wolford survived some of the bloodiest battles of World War I, including Passchendaele and Fumat. He fought in France and Italy and was awarded the Military Cross and returned a hero. But bravery took its terrible toll, and having volunteered to fight at the age of 45, Captain Wolford shot himself dead on the 21st of February 1922.
I will remember my granddad Bruno, born 18th of March in 1927. He lived with his grandparents in Lithuania. When the Nazis started the invasion of Lithuania, my granddad Bruno was identified as a Jew and taken into the concentration camps in the summer of June 1941. He was 14 years of age. He spent 4 years in the concentration camp, and during this time his grandparents went missing. He left the camp in the autumn of 1945. He left at the age of 18, having endured several injuries and losing a finger. He refuses to be defined by a brand of Bruno.
I will remember all those individuals who have returned from the battlefields across the globe, who have suffered amputations and other life-changing injuries. I will also remember my staff, Joe Hughes, Roderick Thompson and Richard Jones, who have served their country. And I will remember the unknown military personnel who returned from all the wars and conflicts, who still fight their individual battles every day.
At 11 a.m. on the 11th day of the 11th month, 1918, the guns across Europe are silent and Armistice Day has born. For 100 years, the nation has now remembered and honoured those who have sacrificed themselves to secure and protect our freedom. However, in 100 years, the image and meaning of war has changed. No longer do we remember just those who have given their lives during conflicts across the globe, but we must also remember the new generation of veterans who serve our country. We must recognise that not all casualties of war return home in a coffin draped with the Union flag. Not all wars are over when nations agree and soldiers return home. Armistice Day is no longer about remembering those who lost their lives in the Great War, but must also be about those servicemen and women who have been affected by war in different ways, whether through physical injury or through the emotional daily battle. Only those who have experienced war can understand, and they must not be forgotten. For many of us, war is a phenomenon seen through the lens of a television camera or a journalist's account of fighting in distant parts of the world. But thousands of service personnel risk their lives to protect the public and, through their role, see and experience some horrific sights. So this year, Walsall College would like to echo the message of the British Legion. Remembrance is also associated with the fallen of the First and Second World Wars. We will always remember them, and we must raise awareness of a new generation of veterans and service personnel that need our support. As for some of them, their war is not over. Thank you to all who served, sacrificed, and changed our world.
I vow to thee, my country, all. Oh.